program is rebroadcast by the Armed Forces Radio Service to our fighting men overseas. Goodyear presents The Roy Rogers Show. The greatest name in rubber, Goodyear, invites you to meet America's greatest Western star, Roy Rogers.
The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken. Then I hung my head and cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. My sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Well, howdy, folks, and welcome to the old ranch house again. This is your Goodyear host, Roy Rogers, with some mighty fine help from little Pat Friday, Bob Nolan and the Sons of the Pioneers, and Perry Botkin, and the Ranch Orchestra. A little later, we're going to bring you a real story of the old days in Texas. And, of course, there'll be plenty of music, so unbuckle your spurs, pull up a big easy chair, and help yourself to a little bit of Western happiness.
That's a swell idea, Roy. I got my spurs off, I got a big easy chair. Now, come on with some of that happiness.
Now, that sounds like Perry Button. Say, Perry, that invitation was meant for all of our guests. You're supposed to be working.
I get awful tired of working all the time. I want to own a ranch and just sit around and keep my guests happy.
That's a nice idea. Maybe I can sort of help you find a good ranch, Perry.
Oh, I got one all picked out. 20 acres of beautiful rolling hillside.
Well, gee, that's fine. When can we go see it?
Just as soon as it stops rolling.
Now, wait a minute, Perry. I don't know whether you could run a ranch like that or not. Do you think you could live on just 20 acres?
Now, just a minute. I'm not that big.
No, I mean, you have to raise enough stuff to live on, you know. What are you going to do when winter comes?
Oh, that's easy. I got a big pile of acorns and a hollow tree.
Say, Perry, I think you better forget about the ranch for a while and get your orchestra ready to play, huh?
All right, but I'm not going to play Don't Fence Me In.
What was that, Perry?
Oh, hello, Pat. Perry doesn't want to play Don't Fence Me In.
Why, I think it's a lovely song. One of Cole Porter's best.
Sure, but we played it last week.
Now, wait a minute. This is kind of silly. Nobody said we were going to play it again this week, Perry.
I know, but I'm just warning you.
Well, what about a brand new Cole Porter song that we've never done on the air, Perry?
You mean you didn't retire after you wrote Don't Fence Me In?
Of course not, Perry. Cole Porter keeps writing big and better songs all the time. And I'll bet I know the new one that Pat's talking about. It's called Every Time We Say Goodbye. Am I right, Pat?
Absolutely right, Roy.
Well, shucks. Perry, will you play that one?
Yeah, well, Pat'll sing it.
That's just what we're figuring on. Here's Pat Friday and Cole Porter's newest song, Every Time We Say Goodbye.
Every time we say goodbye, I wonder why.
thank you very much, Pat. Folks, you know, these are days when plain, honest talk can do a lot to give us people here at home the kind of advice we need. Well, when it comes to advice on what civilian car owners must do to get the country through a serious tire shortage, I guess it's a good idea to rely on the leading tire maker. Wouldn't you say so, Vern?
That's certainly so, Roy. You see, only a tire expert can tell you the best time to have your old tires recapped for longer life. For the added service they must give you these tire-scarce days. Your tire shouldn't be recapped too soon, because that means wasted rubber. And yet you shouldn't wait too long till they've worn over thin, because then they can't be recapped at all. So remember that Goodyear dealers service more tires than any other dealers, and experience like that counts for a lot when it's a question of recapping. Make your Goodyear dealer station your tire service headquarters. Depend on him for the help you need. Your Goodyear dealer will inspect your tires for the danger signs that mean time to recap. He'll tell you the right time, the best time to have that done. And when it is done, have it done the Goodyear way, with Goodyear materials by a Goodyear-trained recap specialist. Yes, for all tire service, rely on the man who's backed up by the greatest name in the rubber industry, Goodyear. Never has Goodyear leadership meant more to you than in the tire service your Goodyear dealer can give you today.
You know, I guess everybody gets a big kick out of life when it's payday, but I'll bet nobody in the world has any more fun with less money than a cowboy. Payday only comes around, well, about every month out in the cow country, but it's sure a beauty while it lasts. Bob Nolan and the Sons of the Pioneers have a swell cowboy song that tells you all about it, so fellas, let's get to cutting and shooting with When Payday Rolls Around, huh?
I'm dressing up in style for in a little while I'm gonna ride into town. And every cowboy pal I know will lift his heel and toe when payday rolls around. And so I'm feeling fine because there's lots of time until we're all homeward bound. To work and slave with cattle, sweat and swear and battle until payday rolls around.
What does a cowboy do when all of his work is through? Just what I'm going to do now. With money to spend and jingle off into town to mingle with all my friends I allow. Maybe a blue-eyed gal will wait for her bronco pal to ride on the hog, there's a crown. True heart and golden hair know that I'll soon be there when payday rolls around.
I'm dressing up in style for in a little while I'm gonna ride. Because there's lots of time until we're all homeward bound. To work and slave with cattle, sweat and swear and battle until payday rolls around. See them tumbling down.
Listen, the music of the West, the music that each week introduces your Goodyear host, Roy Rogers, in another story of the Sunset Country. Roy?
Well, Vern, tonight our story is going to be a little bit different. Out here, the West is mighty proud of the men who rode down the long trails ahead of us. Men like Davy Crockett, Fremont, Pat Garrett, Sam Houston. These men and a lot of others gave us the West that we love today. Tonight, we want to tell the story of one of those men who rode through the wild country down along the border, Tom Barnes. He wasn't a famous man like the rest of them, but he was a Texas Ranger, and that's saying a lot. Vern, I'd kind of like to play the part of Tom Barnes, so will you sort of set the stage?
Texas is a mighty big state. And through the years, it's seen a great many acts of heroism. This may not be the story of a hero, but it's the story of what happened to Tom Barnes one day many years ago in Texas. Down in the Pecos country, late one afternoon, Sylvia Martin stood on the porch of the ranch house, shading her eyes against the sun
and watching as a lone rider came up the dusty trail. As he stopped before the house and dismounted, she recognized the tall, lean figure. It was Tom Barnes of the Texas Rangers. She hurried down the steps to meet him.
Hello, Tom. Oh, I'm so glad to see you.
Well, howdy, Miss Martin. I got your letter and came down here as quick as I could. What's wrong?
It's Father, Tom. Something terrible has happened. He's been arrested. They've put him in jail.
Jed Martin arrested? What for?
For murder, Tom.
Murder?
He's innocent. This whole thing is a frame-up. Bart Williams, who owned the next ranch to ours, was shot one night. Sheriff Caldwell has accused Dad of the killing just because Dad had ridden home from town alone that night and had gone past the Williams place.
I understand. And your father has no way of proving that he didn't do it.
I don't know what to do, Tom. Our ranch and the Williams place are the oldest and largest ranches in the valley. And the sheriff says Dad killed Bart Williams out of jealousy. But Dad wanted to get the Williams place for himself. That's not true, Tom. Well, Dad and Bart Williams were the very best of friends.
I know, Miss Martin, but you try not to worry, huh? I'm going to ride into town and have a talk with Sheriff Caldwell.
Tom Barnes of the Texas Rangers, huh? What's on your mind, Barnes?
Sylvia Martin tells me you're holding her father for the killing of Bart Williams.
That's right. The law's the law. Jed Martin shot Williams, and he's going to swing for it.
You're dealing out your justice pretty sudden, aren't you, Caldwell? How about giving him a trial?
A case like this don't need a trial. I'm sheriff here, and when a man's guilty, I give him what's coming to him. And quick.
I can see that. You know, Sheriff, the Rangers have been keeping their eye on this county down here for quite a while.
What do you mean, Barnes?
I mean that I have a few ideas of my own. Some pretty strange things have been happening around here lately.
I don't like the way you say that, Ranger. Take my advice, young fella, and get out of here. A lot of folks in this town don't care much for Rangers.
Funny thing, Caldwell, when Bob Davis was killed by his horse a while back, his widow sold their ranch. Larry Matson drowned in the river, and his sister sold their ranch. There have been a couple of other cases like that, too. It's sort of a coincidence that Davis's and Matson's and other ranches were all bought up by the same syndicate.
What are you driving at, Barnes?
Nothing, except that I think I know who really killed Bart Williams. And, Sheriff, I'm going to ride over to the county seat tonight, and I'm going to bring back the proof. Good night, Sheriff. Pleasant dreams.
Shortly after sundown, Tom Barnes rode through town and headed along the trail toward the county seat. As his horse jogged along the trail, Tom sat alert in the saddle, watching the skyline of the hills. He was waiting for something which he believed and which he was hoping would happen. And then it happened. From the hillside came spurts of flame and rifle shots. Without a second's hesitation, Tom Barnes wheeled his horse around and headed back toward town. And next morning, he called on Sheriff Caldwell.
What do you want, Barnes?
I thought you'd be interested to know, Sheriff, that you've got some gunmen around here.
It's your own fault you got shot at last night, Barnes. You shouldn't have gone out alone.
I didn't know you knew I was out by myself last night.
What? I didn't, but you said that...
I said nothing of the kind. What's more, Sheriff, you were the only one who knew I was gone last night.
Why, Barnes, I'll blast you to kill
you. Reach for the sky, Caldwell. The Rangers have been waiting to get the man who's working for that syndicate. My men were waiting outside of town last night, and they picked up your gang after the shooting. Now, Sheriff, I have the pleasure of arresting you for the murder of Bart Williams.
You'll never get away with it. My men will...
Your men will do nothing. Listen. Hear that? Those are horses and men riding into town, Caldwell. Some of them are your men. But they won't be able to help you any because they're riding in the custody of the Texas Rangers.
Ride, Ranger, ride. Ride, Ranger, ride.
Pat Friday told me something today, and I've asked her to tell the rest of you about it. It's very interesting, and it's mighty important. Pat?
Well, folks, a friend of mine, a registered nurse, joined the Army Nurse Corps a few months ago. I happened to run into her the other day, and I never saw a girl more enthusiastic about her job. She told me that the great doctors she's working with, the new and advanced methods she uses, and the unusual cases she has to handle are giving her the training she needs to become a real leader in her profession when the war is over. Now, I don't have to tell you that the Army needs nurses. Everyone knows that. But I do want to ask the registered nurses of the country who have not joined the Army Nurses Corps to get in touch with the Surgeon General, United States Army, Washington, D.C., or with their local Red Cross chapter for information. It seems to me that every nurse ought to investigate fully this chance to serve her country in a really vital way and at the same time assure herself of a real future. Thank you.
Well, thank you, Pat. And now, folks, it's just about time for the Farr brothers to get to work on an old time favorite. And here they are, Hugh with his flying fiddle and Carl with his galloping guitar, and the tune is Honeysuckle Rose. Farr brothers really tied that one up with all 10 strings.
I wish I could play guitar, Roy.
Well, I wouldn't worry if I were you, Pat. A guitar can be a lot of trouble.
I don't see why.
Well, first you learn to play a guitar, then playing the guitar makes you want to sing cowboy songs.
What's wrong with that?
Well, nothing, but when you're a cowboy singer, well, you've got to buy a 10-gallon hat, expensive boots, and a lot of fancy clothes.
Well, that does run into money.
Sure, and then folks always come out and say that you're not a real cowboy. Then you have to go buy a horse to prove it. First thing you know, you've got a fortune tied up just because you wanted to play a guitar.
But, Roy, you sing and play a guitar and wear fancy clothes, and you seem to get along all right.
Oh, sure, but with me it's different.
Different? Why?
Well, you see, Trigger makes enough to support both of us.
Well, Trigger's a smart horse, Roy. But he still can't sing. You'll have to take care of that. And it's just about time you did.
All right, Pat. I'll see what I can do about it.
Here's the king of the cowboys, Roy Rogers, singing Tears on My Pillow.
We were so happy when love lingered on. Back in the sweet used to be. Now I'm so lonely because you are gone, leaving a sad memory. Tears on my pillow each morning.
I cry when I dream about you. When I should be sleeping, I just lay there weeping, wondering if you're weeping too. I'm trying so hard to forget you, but that's not so easy to do. With tears on my pillow each morning, tears that I've shed over you.
Tears on my pillow each morning, I cry when I dream about you.
That's not so easy to do. With tears on my pillow each morning, tears that I've shed over you.
Friends, when you're taking your family out for a ride in your automobile, well, you play safe, don't you? You know you've got a mighty precious cargo along, so you don't try to pass other cars on a hill or take any unnecessary chances. But if you have a blowout or sudden tire failure, something that can send your car lurching all over the road, how can you play safe then? You can't. Then it's too late. But with lifeguards in your tires, it's different. You don't have to worry, because the lifeguard made by Goodyear replaces the conventional inner tube and is blowout protection. It's an inner tire within a tube, a two-ply safety tire. And even if your tire and tube blow out, that inner lifeguard remains inflated and supports your car so that it keeps on going smoothly till you can bring it to a safe, sure stop. Yes, along with safety glass, the all-steel body and four-wheel brakes, the lifeguard is one of the four great safety factors of American motoring. Right now, because of wartime conditions, Goodyear is not producing lifeguards, but Goodyear hopes to be turning them out again soon so that those of you who haven't the protection of lifeguards now can get them before too long. Until then, remember, there's one device that makes any blowout harmless: the lifeguard, Goodyear's modern safety successor to the inner tube.
Folks, somebody once said, the West is like a sweetheart. You may lose her, but you'll never forget her. He sure knew what he was talking about. I don't know what it is that we love about the West. I can't rope it and fence it in words for you, but maybe it's a combination of the country and the people. Maybe it's the way of living that we think it's a little bit better than any other way. I suppose Badger Clark, our great Western poet, got about as close to it as anyone in one of the poems in his book, Sun and Saddle Leather. Anyhow, what he put down in his cowboy prayer is sure worth saying again. Oh Lord, I've never lived where churches grow. I love creation better as it stood the day you finished it so long ago and looked upon your work and called it good. Just let me live my life as I've begun, and give me work that's open to the sky. Make me a partner of the wind and sun, and I won't ask a life that's soft and high. Make me as big and open as the plains, as honest as the horse between my knees, clean as the wind that blows behind the reins, and free as the hawk that circles down the breeze. Just keep an eye on all that's done and said. Just write me sometimes when I turn aside, and guide me along the dim trail ahead that stretches upward toward the great divide. Last night, as I lay on the prairie and gazed at the stars in the sky, I wondered if ever the cowboy would drift to that sweet by and by. Looks like it's time to bed down another Goodyear get-together out here at the ranch. Why don't you just saddle up and come riding over next week at the same time? Miss Pat Friday, Bob Nolan and the Sons of the Pioneers, and Perry Botkin and the Ranch Orchestra have all promised to be here, and we'll sure be mighty proud to have you. So until next week at the same time, this is Roy Rogers saying for the whole gang, goodbye, good luck, and may the good Lord take a liking to you. Don't forget, smiles are made out of the sunshine and a frown from a rainy day. You'll be more than repaid if you remember that a smile goes a long, long way. When trouble troubles you, just turn on the sun and watch how fast your cares and worries starting to run. Don't forget, smiles are made out of the sunshine, and a smile goes a long, long way. Don't forget, smiles are made.
Roy Rogers and Bob Nolan and the Sons of the Pioneers appeared through the courtesy of Republic Pictures. This is Vern Smith saying goodnight for Goodyear, the greatest name in rubber, and reminding you that more people ride on Goodyear tires than on any other kind. Be with us next Tuesday, same time, same station, when Goodyear will bring you another get-together at the ranch with Roy Rogers, the King of the Cowboys. Sure.